in 2018, we had some wiring upgrades that we had to do. And when the electricians got above the false ceiling, the grid actually fell down in the sanctuary. And so then we had to quickly repair that. And we knew at that time that we had to do something.
Mary Shoneman is parish council president. The choice was to either repair a 100-year-old building or do a complete restoration.
We decided that we needed to go ahead and do the restoration. And so we started a capital campaign to reach our goal. And within 6 weeks, we had 80% of our goal reached. And at that time, I believe that was around March of 21, we got the okay from Bishop DeGrude to go ahead and proceed with the restoration because we had collected that much money.
And then the pandemic stopped the project in its tracks. So during that time, the council, under the guidance of then parish priest Father Timothy Smith, arranged for a contractor and all the subcontractors, and in January 2022, work began.
Father Smith worked tirelessly to get this going, and the bishop was in agreement because we were able to raise that money so fast, and I think all the parishioners were committed to it, so I think it was a good sign that we wanted to have it done.
Services were held in the parish hall as the building was stripped to the studs, modernized, and rebuilt. The project also confirmed the congregation's commitment to each other.
I think as a whole, our group has been really good. You know, anybody that was asked to do anything, there was never a no. It just, they came ahead and did it, you know, and we're a farm community, so these people are busy. So, yeah, so it's been great.
One major change order along the way, near the end of the restoration, Father Smith moved to Windom, Minnesota, and Father Tim Cohn arrived, but not just in Leola. That's the second part of our story, how a parish priest divides his time between three communities that are an 80-mile round trip.
Yeah, all right.
As time has gone on, just the number of priests have gone down, as well as the shifting demographics in the rural communities and stuff, where so many people move into the cities, it's just happening much more now than ever before.
And even more so in surrounding states. But even though the week is driven by specific times for Mass and confessions, the rest takes planning and the right frame of mind.
You know, I don't have an office in each location, so I've got to take what I need with me to each of these locations. And so just much more pre-planning on my part. But one of the benefits of it is I actually enjoy screen time or windshield time, you know, because that's a chance for me just to, honestly, I end up praying during most of that time, spending time with our Lord, kind of checking in.
This is farm country, so the distances are not surprising. What is the way Father Cohn, a city boy, has embraced it.
I've been so surprised by these smaller communities. I mean, just number one, their love for their faith. The roots run deep here. Those who live by the land, I'm finding more and more have such deep faith. And it's encouraging to me. I mean, I didn't grow up on a farm, you know, I'm a city guy. And then just to see the faith of those from Leola, it's beautiful. I mean, and this is a parish named after our Blessed Mother, and they absolutely love our Blessed Mother. it's encouraging to see that for me personally.
And less than 9 months after construction started, the parishioners of Our Lady of Perpetual Help celebrated a restoration mass.
It's beautiful. I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. And to see people, they're so excited to get back into their church. I mean, this is where so many of them grew up. This is where they were baptized. This is where they received all their sacraments. It means so much to them. And so to have it put back to its original splendor and glory, it's amazing.